engineers come to the position that they're at with a lot of technical knowledge and a lot of experience in the technical aspects of their job. But by the time they move from individual contributor to managing people or even managing managers, they tend to find that there are some interpersonal skills, some leadership skills that are missing, that they just didn't get along the way. And this certificate is meant to help them address that. So I focus on what are the actual skills of leadership and how can we practice those and reflect on them. So there's a lot of reflective learning in the way I teach. I really enjoy just sort of throwing people into the deep end, letting them flounder around for a while, and then pulling them out and taking a look at what worked and what didn't. I really think that this sort of experience plus reflection is a great way to learn these skills. So based on all of the various different groups I've taught over the years, a colleague of mine and I have sort of taken out what we call the four pillars of effective leadership. And what we found is that if any of these pillars or areas are missing in somebody's leadership, they're just not effective or not as effective as they could be. So one of the pillars is knowledge. Particularly engineering leaders need to know their stuff, right? They need to be very competent at what they do to gain the respect in the organization. The second pillar is insight. And that's where a lot of this self-reflection and self-analysis comes in. The other two pillars are ability or experience, so you have to practice the stuff that you're learning, and then courage. So courage is built into what we do from the beginning, and those are all sort of intertwined in the certificate program.